My dear students, welcome to Karnataka LMS. Myself, Suguna HG, working as assistant professor at GFGC and PG Center, Chintamani. In this video, I am going to present you Mathematics Paper 3, Unit 1, Group Theory, Session 9, Theorems on Subgroups. Here we are going to discuss few simple theorems on subgroup. We are familiar with the definition of the subgroup. That is, if H is a subgroup of G, then H itself has to satisfy all the properties of the groups. Means H itself is a group. Now, let us discuss few theorems on this. Theorem 1, if H, K, L are any three subsets of a group G, then show that H, K into L is equal to H into KL. Now to prove this one, consider the LHS of the above result, that is HK into L. That is nothing but a set HK into L is equal to set small h small k L such that H belongs to H, K belongs to K and L belongs to capital L. See here, H, K, L are three subsets of G. So we have considered HK into L is a set that is equal to HK into L such that H is an element of capital H, K is an element of K, L is an element of L. Now let us interchange the brackets here. HKL is written as H into KL. Okay, HK into L is written as H into KL such that all these three elements, that is H belongs to H, K belongs to K and L belongs to H, and which is equal to HKL, H into KL, because H belongs to capital H, K and L are belonging to K and L sets again. So this is equal to H of KL. Now see, we have taken HK into L and proved H into KL. So this implies that HK into L is equal to H into KL. Hence the proof. Next theorem, theorem 2. For any two subsets H and K of a group G, show that HK all inverse is equal to K inverse H inverse. Proof. Again, let us consider the LHS HK whole inverse, and HK whole inverse is equal to H and K such that H belongs to H and K belongs to K, and which is equal to K inverse H inverse such that H belongs to H and K belongs to K. Means for every element H belongs to H, the inverse exists, that is H inverse. K belongs to K implies K inverse belongs to K. Hence, K inverse H inverse. Next theorem 3. If H is a subgroup of G, then show that H inverse is equal to H. Means inverse of a subgroup is equal to H. We have to show that. Now to prove this, consider H belongs to H. Small h belongs to H implies that H inverse is also present in H, because H is a subgroup of G, H itself is a group. Hence, every H belongs to H implies H inverse belongs to H. This implies H inverse whole inverse also belongs to H inverse. See, we have taken inverse both sides. So, H inverse whole inverse belongs to H inverse. Further, this implies H belongs to H inverse, which implies H is a subset of H inverse. Now see, H inverse whole inverse means it is nothing but H. It is H. H belongs to H inverse. This implies that H is a subset of H inverse. Let us take this as equation 1. Then again, let X belongs to H inverse, which implies X belongs to H inverse. For H belongs to H, which implies H inverse belongs to H. Further, this implies X belongs to H, and this implies that H inverse is a subset of H. Now see, from 1 and 2, H is a subset of H inverse, and H inverse is a subset of H, which is possible only when these two sets are equal. Hence, H inverse is equal to H. Hence the proof. Next theorem. Theorem 4. Subset H of a group G is a subgroup of G if and only if H inverse is equal to H. See, H becomes a subgroup of G if this condition satisfies. That is, H inverse is equal to H. Proof. Let H be a subgroup of G. Let X belongs to H inverse. And this implies X is equal to AB inverse, where A and B belongs to H. Let H be a subgroup of G, and let X belongs to HH inverse. X is equal to AB inverse. Since H is a subgroup of G, A and B belongs to H. Further, this implies AB inverse belongs to H. That is, X belongs to H. We have taken X belongs to HH inverse, and we proved that X belongs to H. Therefore, this implies HH inverse is a subset of H. Similarly, again, let H belongs to H. Again, let H belongs to H implies H is equal to HE inverse, which belongs to HH inverse. Because H is an element of H, so E inverse is the element of H inverse. Further, this implies that H is a subset of HH inverse. Now, from 1 and 2, HH inverse is a subset of H, and H is a subset of HH inverse. This is possible if both the sets are equal. Therefore, from 1 and 2, HH inverse is equal to H. Then the last theorem, theorem 5. If H and K are subgroups of G, then HK is a subgroup of G if and only if HK is equal to KH. Now, to prove that HK is equal to KH, let HK be a subgroup of G, and then HK is equal to HK inverse, HK whole inverse by the previous result, K inverse H inverse. By the previous theorem, HK whole inverse is equal to K inverse H inverse. So that is equal to KH. HK is equal to KH. This is hence the proof. Then conversely, let us consider HK is equal to KH, and HK inverse is equal to HKK inverse H inverse, group K inverse H inverse together here. Then this implies that HKK inverse we have taken together into H inverse, that is equal to HKH inverse. So KK inverse is equal to K, that's also by the previous result, therefore, which is equal to HK into H inverse, that is equal to KH into H inverse, because HK is equal to KH. So KHK H inverse is equal to KH H inverse, that is equal to KHH inverse, which is equal to KH. HH inverse is H, which is equal to KH. K into HH inverse is equal to KH, where HH inverse is equal to H, which implies that HK is subgroup of G. KH is equal to HK implies that HK is a subgroup of G. Thank you.